Two hands, Al.
One of the things we came here for today is we wanted to get a little bit of family history from you and ask you about some stuff. So I brought with a little like voice recorder so we can record it so we don't forget what you tell us. So if that's okay with you, and I'm guessing it is, right? Sure. Then we're gonna record what we talk about today, and we'll have your voice on the recorder so we don't forget the important stuff.
Let me tell you that the hot dog is delicious.
Good.
The pickle is great.
Yeah, I didn't know if I should bring you fries or stuff like that, but usually you like to focus on the hot dog and the shake. Is the shake good?
Mm-hmm. How are you guys?
We're doing okay. I was driving down the street today, and I saw some guy walking, and I said, gee, that looks like Sherwin. So I pulled over, and I said, are you Sherwin? And he says, no. I said, I don't believe you. He says, no. Anyway, I convinced him he was Sherwin, so he came with.
Yeah. It's nice seeing the guy.
And, you know, in the future, if you want two hot dogs, let me know. We'll bring you two of them. We're going to let you eat mostly. When you have something to say, just shout it out.
Yeah. How are you? How are your family?
Fine, thank you. Fine. Yes.
Forgive me for asking on your family.
Wait a minute. Chew and swallow, then you can talk.
Yeah, don't try and talk while you're chewing. It's too much food.
I got news for you. Too much of everything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Too much love. And
we're here? Why do you say that? What goes on
here? True. I can't tell you how good this is.
What, the food?
Your presents.
Oh, the presents? What do you like more, the presents or the food?
The present.
Okay. See, I think he wants us to bring him more presents in the future.
You want to know something?
What?
Everything is just wonderful.
Yeah?
You like it here? Do you like it here?
Oh, I like it. How's the weather outside?
Very nice.
Good.
We were almost talking about taking you out today to eat, but We weren't sure how good your walking was. So we figured we'll come here and find out, and maybe the next time we'll take you out for a field trip for lunch. But right now we gotta fatten you up first.
What?
I said we gotta fatten you up.
Yeah,
so
I'm real fat. Right. Skinny. Thank you, guys.
Do you look skinny? How do you feel?
I feel fine, sure.
Yeah. Oh, that's good. Do you like this place better than the other place you were in?
They're all the same.
They're all the
sure.
same, huh? Uh-huh. Well. How are the people here that...
What?
How are the people here, the nurses and the people...
They're all great.
Yeah? Oh, good. Any nice-looking women here?
No, women I don't like.
Oh.
How I know he's demented. It set in.
Uh-huh. Steve, you don't have any women at all.
I'm looking now. You know, seriously.
He's got an ad in the newspaper.
That's what my sister said. She's gonna. I kind of doubt it.
Steve, I got news for you.
Yeah.
If you don't find someone, your time is passing.
I know. But you know, I had to take care of my mother for quite a while, so that was part of it.
You did a good job.
Yeah, well, I tried, but you know, I've never been satisfied with anything I did, so I always felt like I should have done better.
I want you to know all these things here are great.
Good.
So, Tommy, did you see Paul over the weekend?
Well, forgive me, Sherwin, I or whatever your name is.
Sam.
we can always change his name.
Yeah. So what, answer me, did you see Paul over the weekend?
If I can only think. I think so.
You think so? Was he here with anybody else?
I don't know, Paul.
No?
Is it hard to think and remember and eat at the same time?
No.
What's better, the hot dog or the shake? You can wait to answer until you're done swallowing.
I'll tell you. I think everything is better.
Good. Good. He does pretty well with the left hand, surprisingly well.
If you got any plans for this afternoon, follow the plan schedule.
I'm not, I don't have much plan.
We decided to come and spend a little time with you.
Yeah, we'll go after.
That's very exciting.
After you're done eating, you will put on your bathing suit and we'll go down to the pool and go swimming.
Yeah, but we don't want to have a water problem in this town, too.
You're both nuts.
You know, it's talk about swimming.
Talk up a little louder.
Talk about swimming. Do you remember Esther Williams?
Mm-hmm.
Well, how do you remember?
If I remember, that she was a great swimmer. Go ahead.
No, I didn't know if you remembered her.
Why not? She died?
Yeah, she died.
I think a long time ago, wasn't it?
Yeah, a few months.
Yeah. Were you a good swimmer, Al?
No.
No?
I had trouble floating. Esther Williams, it's an unreal. She couldn't have been very old.
No, she was up in age, yeah.
Yeah. Talk up.
She was up in age. I'm talking up. Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Oh.
And she died?
They buried her.
When?
Oh, a couple months ago.
You know who just died? Edie Gourmet.
Who?
Edie Gourmet. Do you remember her?
Edie Gourmet?
Yeah.
I don't remember her at all.
I think she was married to Steve Lawrence. Remember Steve Lawrence?
Was he a singer?
Yeah. Probably not a big Edie Gourmet fan.
No, but he knew Steve Lawrence.
Yeah.
Guys, I only know one thing.
What?
Time passes, and we all pass with the time.
Right.
Thank you.
Well, that hot dog is almost gone. Should I have brought you another hot dog, Al?
No, sir. You did just fine.
All right. See, I thought this place would make a good hot dog because they charbroil them fresh. And, you know, and it's a jumbo.
Yeah. Well.
Yeah. Did you like salami and hot dogs years ago?
Salami and hot dogs? I don't know, sir.
No?
I really don't know.
Well, I think, didn't you have a brother that liked salami and hot dogs?
What was the name of your oldest brother? Your older brother, I should say.
Joe? Where is he?
Well, he passed away a number of years ago.
Don't you remember when your brother Joe passed away? No?
Those are the sad memories that I don't want to remember too much.
But you do remember, you just don't want to, yes?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's the difference.
Joe Klassman had the most magnificent voice in the world.
Really?
He could sing like an angel.
I didn't know that.
He did sing like an angel.
Now, what was his wife's name?
Clara.
Okay.
Was that her name?
Yeah, I think so.
I don't think they like one another after a while.
Yeah.
Oh, really? Did you remember his children's name?
His children, not really.
One was very popular. You know, I thought you knew him.
Do you remember the names of any of Joe's kids?
No.
No?
No? Does it come back to you?
It may, but none.
If I threw out some names to you, would it help you?
What?
If I gave you some names, would that help you recall? I'm going to see, I got some names floating around in my head, but I'm not sure which ones are right, so maybe I'll tell you the ones I'm thinking of, but you can tell me if I'm right or wrong. Did he have a son named Charlie?
Oh, Charlie was a nice kid.
Was Charlie Joe's son, or did he, or was his kid not Charlie? I don't remember.
I don't remember.
Don't remember? Did he have a son named Larry?
Larry, yeah. He was a nice kid.
Yeah. Was he the youngest, or in the middle, or the oldest? Did you remember?
I think he was the middle.
Middle? Okay.
Am I guessing right?
I'm not sure. That's why we came here, is we wanted to get all this family information from you. Mm.
What are you looking for?
You want to know? I don't know what I'm looking for. I'm just looking to find things.
Oh, okay.
You know, things disappear from your memory. And one thing that disappeared, Claire Klassman?
Yeah.
Was she a witch?
I've heard some people say that.
Did you know her?
I think I did.
Was she a witch? Do you remember
her
being a witch?
I think she went to California or something.
Yeah.
Is that right?
I heard Florida, but I'm not sure. Wherever she went, it wasn't far enough. Now, what was the name of your parents? Your mother and father?
Dylan David,
okay.
What are you guys doing, Ted?
No, I told you, we want to get some history. Do you... I'll let you drink. For a minute. Just take it easy. Swallow slow. Do you remember what town your mother and father came from in Europe?
I think Kiev, if I'm not mistaken.
Kiev?
Okay. No, that was close.
Yeah. Does... wait. Does the name Tatiev ring a bell at all? Tatiev?
Europe?
Yeah.
Russia?
Yeah.
Yep. And pick up the cell phone. Hey, come here.
What? There's only pickles there.
I think so. I know. I think I know. Go ahead.
How are your arithmetic skills, your math skills? Are they still pretty good? Can you still do any, like, multiplying or dividing or adding or subtracting?
I don't know, Kevin.
All right. I mean, for example, take a drink. Could you still, say, multiply 7 by times 7?
Oh, yeah.
What would that be?
49.
Okay. And how about 16 plus 12?
That's 28, I think.
Okay. And how about...
what the hell is this quiz thing?
I'm just kind of checking some things. You know I'm a doctor.
I think you are.
Okay. You'd do it for me, wouldn't you, after I brought you that nice big hot dog and the drink?
I would do anything for
you. Okay, thank you, Al. And how about 43 minus 14? Do you know 43 minus 14?
Wait, one moment.
Okay.
-14?
Yeah.
I think that would be something like, I don't know.
Is that too hard?
Mm-mm. If you don't mind, I'd like to call this game quiz.
Okay, we can go to a can we go to a different game?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Do you remember your house in Elk Grove Village?
Yeah.
What street was that on?
I think Placid and Harmony.
That's right.
Guys, I'm getting awful tired.
What, tired of thinking or tired of eating?
Tired of everything.
Oh. Mm. How old are you now, Al?
Roughly, I think I'm about in the 80s.
Okay.
Eighty plus,
okay. Do you remember the last time I visited you?
Mm-mm.
No? You don't remember when I visited you last?
Do you remember what the musical instrument you played?
A trumpet.
Oh, yeah. I remember that.
I still have it.
You still have it, huh?
Your father would have probably made more money in the glass repair business.
Give me that again.
I said your father would have probably made more money in the glass repair business.
I don't know.
What did he do?
I don't know that either. But he was a good working man.
Somebody told me that he went into business with Aaron Weisbond. Did you ever hear that? That he got his start in business from Aaron Weisbond?
Aaron Weisbond.
Yeah.
Okay, I think that's right.
Yeah.
Who was Aaron Weisbond?
Aaron Weisbond was my grandfather.
Oh.
I think. Guys, I'm through here.
You're not gonna drink the rest of the milkshake?
Nope.
You don't like it, huh?
It's good, but I just too much.
Want to take a rest for a little bit from eating?
Yeah.
All right.
You know, all these memories don't make me too happy. They just bring up sad recollections.
But there's a lot of good recollections.
What?
There's a lot of good recollections that you've had.
Wow.
How many children do you have?
I think I had three. Four?
Well, I'm asking,
I don't know.
Well, what are their names? That way we'll know for sure. How many?
I don't know that either.
Oh, come on, Al. You remember.
Maybe the thing is I don't want to remember.
Why don't you want to remember? Those are the niceties of life.
Excuse me.
How many daughters and how many sons?
I wish I would have had more daughters and sons.
Well, how many sons do you have?
I think I have Two, I think.
What's their names?
Well, this quizzing is getting me a little tired. And besides, my nose is running.
Well, we'll get you a Kleenex. Do you want me to get you a Kleenex?
If you want.
Okay. How much are you going to pay me?
What?
How much are you going to pay me to get you a Kleenex?
$1,000.
$1,000? Where do you keep your money? I'll take it myself.
I'll tell you, I wish
I don't know where you got the Kleenex.
I wish I had money.
There's a pack of M&M's. Maybe I'll take that instead.
M&M candies?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll go for that now.
Oh, okay.
I didn't even know I had. Oh, would you open it for me?
Sure.
Very nice of you.
All right. Well, if I open it, you got to answer. You got to tell me the names of your children.
All right.
Oh, you want me to pour it now?
No.
God, you really want service.
I demand service. What do you want?
These are M&M's with peanuts. You demand service.
Thank you.
I gotta find you a Kleenex.
Be a good boy and sit down.
I gotta find you a Kleenex. You put me to work. I don't know where they keep them. What kind of a hotel is this? Or whatever this place is. Let's see. There's toilet tissue. That's not a good substitute.
Mmm. Sure, that good.
Yeah? Will you sell me one for a quarter?
I'll give you one free.
No, that's okay. I don't want to cut into your...
Can I have a Kleenex?
Yeah, I gotta go ask where they got them.
Mmm. Use toilet paper.
Nah, we don't want to use toilet paper.
Candy all over. Shit.
Here, I got some. Yeah. Paul, here's a box.
Get some toilet paper.
That is Kleenex. Here. It's all you need. Yeah, don't put the M&M's in liquid water because they'll melt. You're supposed to melt in your mouth, not on your hands. So
sit
what?
Down.
So okay, but we want to know what are the names of your kids?
The present here.
your current children. What are their names? I told you we're taking a little bit of a family history from you.
We'd
like you to cooperate. I realize you don't always want to do it, but you can help us. We just want to know the names of your children, if you can. Will tell us.
Are you doing me a favor?
What?
Go fly a kite.
Well, I knew that was coming. How do you know he knows how to fly a kite?
Here I am, Al. I just gave you some M&M's, and you're not being nice to me. Did I deserve that comment? Are you just being a touch ornery?
What?
Are you just being a touch ornery?
No.
No.
Well, very nice guy.
Okay. Well, Sherwin and I are making a family history. We want to know the names of your kids.
Come over here.
Come over there? What do you want? You going to hit me?
You
want more M&M's? Okay. Well, we've already got two on the floor. So.
I'll eat them off the floor.
No, we're not going to do it. But we're having a high attrition rate.
Yeah, I know. That's enough.
Okay.
Well, what day is today?
Today, I think, is... Let me look. I think today is Tuesday.
Are you not working?
Oh, no, I retired. Do you know what I used to do when I was working?
What?
I'm asking you.
I think you were an accountant.
Oh.
I got a question for you, Al.
Yeah, I know.
Are you going to tell me today the names of your kids?
What?
Are you going to tell me the names of your kids?
I don't know.
Are you close with your children?
I think so.
Okay.
You like those M&Ms?
Yes, I do.
Next time when you come...
Wrong end. You're trying to pour out of the closed end.
What?
You were trying to pour them out of the closed end. You got to pour them out of the open end. You want
well,
me to do it?
If I could see the open end,
I'd I'll do
right.
it for you. I hope there's some left. Hey, you got it. You got it. You got it. All right, there. You're pouring too many. No. I think we just lost a few more. Here's one right here. And there's one on your shirt.
Are you having trouble seeing, Al?
Yeah, he is.
I've had trouble for a long time.
Really? Oh.
You look pretty good.
I look pretty good for the condition I'm in.
What?
I look pretty good for the condition I'm in. You
You're
know.
In a good condition.
Yeah.
Sit down, baby.
Where should I sit? Should I sit over here on this bed? I'll sit over...
wherever you want.
I'll sit up here. This way you can see me better.
Well, tell me, what do you got to do all your free time? But well, the hair.
I chase women, and what do you do?
I follow you to get the ones that don't want you.
You're okay, guys. What I'm going to do right now
is take off my nap.
What?
You want to take a nap.
How did you guess?
I'm smart. I know you. Every time I come, after a few minutes of talking to you, you want to take a nap.
And where's my bed?
Are you asking me the questions?
Yeah, where's the bed?
I don't know.
Go out, guys, get your clothes together and leave. I'm going to bed for a while.
But you're kicking us out, huh?
Kicking you out, not intentionally, but just because I want to rest a bit.
Uh-huh. Do you get tired easily?
Oh, yeah.
Why is that?
Why?
Why?
How do I know? It's the guy upstairs who makes the decisions.
About that kind of stuff?
Yeah.
Okay.
And you know, want to know something? I'm tired now. I'm going to take this towel. I think it's a towel. Go wipe my face. I may lay down in that friendly bed.
What color is the blanket on that bed? Are you able
Don't
to
ask
see?
Me such silly questions.
Well, I'm just curious. You said your eyesight's not good. I wanted to see if you can tell what color it is.
Well, as a doctor, you know that people have troubles.
I do, but I'm just trying to find out if it's so bad that you can't tell the color. That's all I'm asking. I'm not trying to be mean. I'm trying to help
Here,
you.
Here, hold this towel, and I'm going to go lay down.
Okay.
And fellas, I want to wish you a good day. I'll see you later, maybe.
Wait, can you get out of the chair without the alarm going off?
I think so.
Doesn't the alarm go off if you get out of the chair?
I don't know, Paul. Don't ask me.
Who, Paul? Who's Paul?
You know, my son, Poi.
What's your son's name?
Paul.
Oh, Paul. Oh, okay.
I call him Poi.
Poi.
Because it rhymes with boy. Boy the boy.
He was a nice, he's a nice guy. And I'll miss him very much.
Why would you miss him?
Because I'm going to leave pretty soon. And don't ask me where I'm going. Because I know where I'm going. I know exactly where I'm going. Mm-hmm. Right now I'm going to lay down. And
did you buy a ticket yet?
Yes.
You did?
Yes.
How much was it?
It was expensive, but I don't care what money costs. I just spend, man.
Now you're being funny.
You're absolutely right. You know, guys, I miss your mom so much. It drives me crazy.
Whose mom?
Wilma.
Oh. Well, it's not my mom. Was your wife. But it's really bothering you a lot, huh?
Oh, sure. But you hide it. Fellas, I want you to get... I have to charge you for sitting on that seat.
Now you remember that you told me the other week you remember that my mother passed away, right?
Yes, I did. That's a shame.
She always liked you.
What?
She always cared for you, my mother.
Yeah, I thought so. How old was she?
99.
Wow, that's a good age. Yeah. Nice age. But it's a shame that people have to die.
You're absolutely right.
People should just fade away.
Well, you know how I feel about it is maybe at a certain point.
Don't cry, Steve.
No, well, you know, it's still tough for me. I kind of feel like when people get to a certain... Yeah, it would be nice if maybe like once a month for an hour you could call them. Yeah. You know, and yeah, maybe they can't be there all the time, but you know, I'd like to be able to talk to my mother and for once a month or something. Even, and I'm sure Sherwin will
love
like
you.
To...
I love Sherwin very much, but I'm going to tell you one thing. Good night. Oh boy, I'll tell you. I always miss this place.
Which place?
This place. It was a warm place, a nice place.
How long have you been here?
A long time, I think.
Where are you going?
I'm going to where all great people go. I could not call myself great, but I'm going where...
Do you need another Kleenex? Your nose looks a little drippy.
You want to know something? I don't have to go good Kleenex. I got it right here.
Okay.
And you want to know something else?
Yes.
I'm going to bid you both a good evening and a good day or whatever. And maybe, just maybe, this will be my time.
Time for what?
Ah, shit.
Can you get up by yourself?
Oh, yeah.
If you need my help, you let me know.
No, if I need your help, I'll call God.
You got a direct line?
I have a direct line. Get up, you damn old fool. I'm all right.
No, you're not.
I'm all right. So, bed.
A little bad. If you need a handout, I'll give it to you.
I know that, Stephen, and I appreciate that very much, but I still think I can get up on my own.
Okay. Well, we'd like to get you walking a little better and you know, moving around a little better. When you're ready for me to help you, I'll give you a little lift.
All right.
When you just tell me.
Hey, can I give me a Kleenex? Clear my nose is running.
Sure. Here.
Thank you. Okay, no, stop it. Isn't it funny? You have to depend upon wooden things to get away from me.
Okay. Said to get away. You want a little handout? I'll give you a little.
No.
Okay.
You can applaud. Thank you. Here's my hands.
Wait.
Sometimes. Thank you.
Now, you want me to swing you around a little?
I'll get on my own.
All right, we'll let you try. Don't forget, you got some milkshake left. We'll put that by your bed when you get...
Put it by the refrigerator.
I don't even know if there is a refrigerator. Got a little piece of hot dog in the chair.
Isn't this a way funny? A life has to end this way.
Who says life is ending?
I think so.
Yeah? Well,
you haven't used up all your money, Albert.
I never had much, but...
Let me help you get onto the pillow a little better, Al.
You're absolutely right. I need help.
Okay.
But,
let's swing you this
way. Okay, that's nice. Hey, guys. Thank you both.
Let's pull you up this way a little more.
All right.
You want to slide up?
Thank you both. I wanted to thank you.
Say
hello to all your
friends. You want me to pull you up on the bed a little more? Maybe a little more, Al.
Whatever you think.
Yeah. I'm using my medical judgment.
Yeah. Well,
I'm gonna give you a little schlep here.
Thank you.
That's okay.
I'll take off my shoes.
Okay.
Thank you. You're very kind, both of you.
I'll put them right here. I'm gonna put your M&M's are, well, that was the last one. I'm gonna put this up here.
Okay.
I'm gonna put that up there for when you want it.
All right.
I'm gonna put Kleenex
right
over
here. Thanks.
You want me to move this little table closer?
No. This table is gonna.
You want me to put a little bit of music on?
That would be nice.
Okay.
Has he got his radio?
Yeah, it's right there. It's right there. If I can figure out how to work it.
Yeah. I've worked it before.
We want...
I got news for it. It'll go out by itself.
Well, that's the radio, but we actually want the...
I don't know if we've got any CDs.
Well, I bought them some. I don't know if they're in here.
Where are the CDs, Al?
Harvey?
Where are the CDs that you can play in there? The CDs, the round CDs?
Yeah, I know what you're talking about. I'm peeing in my pants right now, excuse me.
Okay.
Another symptom.
Another what?
Symptom.
Symptom of what?
Of peeing.
Oh, okay.
In your pants.
It's not a symptom. It's a narishgeit.
Can you pee straight?
What?
Can you pee straight?
I think so.
You're in good shape then.
Why don't you apply for a job? Why don't you apply for a job with the fire department?
God bless you both. Hey, do me a favor.
What?
Go home.
I want to get your radio on for you if I could figure out how to work the damn
thing. Well, let's get the radio on.
Why should your radio be so hard?
Well, yeah. I thought you had a CD player because I remember I bought you CDs.
CD player,
well, how do you open it?
Just a minute. Don't. This is. Okay, just a
second. Hey, guys, it's been very nice having you.
CD mode program.
You can't get it on it?
Well, I gotta figure out how to open the box with the CD so
okay,
I can.
Just relax.
There must be a button to press.
I've been pressing buttons.
Tell me, are we plugged in?
Okay, there we go.
Okay, what is that?
That's some movie themes from Steve R.
Oh.
What do you know? Now I gotta figure out who might Steve R be?
No idea.
And we gotta get it to play.
Okay, relax.
Drop it on the floor once, huh?
There it goes.
Well, maybe. Oh, there you go. You got it.
Oh, that's one of my favorite beers.
Well, that's why I put it on there.
Hey, guys.
This is from a movie.
Absolutely.
This is a great
movie.
The theme
from The Seahawk, which he loves.
Seahawk?
Yeah, you remember the movie
Errol Flynn?
Yeah. Bell and the Seahawk. In fact, I played in my car for him once. He said, oh, I love it. All right, I'll put a bunch of themes on a CD for you. So I did. I burned him a couple CDs.
Hey, guys.
Yeah.
You're making too much noise. Keep quiet. I love this piece of music.
Yeah?
Oh, listen to it.
Chances
it's almost godly.
Who wrote this music?
What's his name? Eric Wolfgang Korngold.
Yes, that's what I was going to think. He came over as a DP.
Mm-hmm. Oh, he was wonderful.
Listen
so
to it.
When you look at him, he looks so happy.
Anyway, that's the way we should all go.
Turn it up a little louder, okay. Please.
All right.
That, Steve, that's on the louder business, a button.
Yeah, I figured the volume.
All right, that's a little better, I think. I love this part of this.
Did Errol Flynn come out yet?
Errol Flynn is not in this.
Errol Flynn is not in that.
Well, he was in the movie.
Thank you.